raw food diet. Thank you so much for following me this far. And if you're just joining me, I will quickly fill you in. I am a vegan, and today I'm wearing my plant eater shirt, which I got at the Vegan Fest in Asheville a few months ago. So I already do not eat any meat, dairy, or eggs. And over the past 17 days, I haven't had any cooked foods. So I've been eating all raw fruits and vegetables, mostly smoothies and juices. So being that I'm not going to be eating any cooked food for the next 11 days anyway, I figured there was no better time than now to start a master cleanse. So I've already started it today and I'm drinking the lemonade now. I will be doing this for the next 10 days and then on my 28th day of the raw food diet, I will go back to the juices and smoothies. And the same thing for the day after, in the morning and probably for lunch, I will also have raw fruit and vegetables to prepare my system for a cooked meal later that night. The Master Cleanse calls for a mixture of lemon juice, maple syrup, and cayenne pepper that you drink throughout the day, a salt water flush in the morning, and an herbal laxative tea at night. Because I'm on a raw food diet, I have altered this recipe slightly, which I will explain in a few minutes. But first, I would like to say that I do understand that there is a lot of controversy surrounding this detox, and I have been back and forth on whether or not I would like to go through with it. And after a lot of research, I have decided to go through with it. I have previously done a master cleanse about 6 years ago, and the results were amazing. So I'm extra excited about it this time, being that I've already been cleansing my body for the past 17 days with raw food. So I'm excited to see if the benefits will be even more. So here are the ingredients that I have, and I will explain each one. So being that I committed to 4 weeks raw with no salt, I have spent days researching, trying to figure out how I can do this without going back on my previous commitment and if that was even possible. So I will start with the salt. This is a non-genetically modified sea salt, and the sea salt water flush calls for 2 teaspoons of sea salt and 32 ounces of warm water every morning. Now, I originally considered skipping this step, being that I committed to no salt. However, after researching more, I realized this is a very important step in the cleansing process, and it's not the same as putting salt on food and eating it. The salt in the water will not separate and will thoroughly wash the entire digestive tract. And this is the most effective way to cleanse the colon. The salt water has the same gravity as the blood, so the kidneys will not pick up the water and the blood will not pick up the salt. So this is in no way a harmful process. So next is the lemonade, which you drink throughout the day. And the recipe calls for the juice of a half of a lemon, 1/10 teaspoon of organic cayenne pepper, and 2 tablespoons of maple syrup. So being that the maple syrup is not raw, I had been searching for alternatives to the sweetener, which I can use. It was suggested that I use a raw cane sugar juice, but I could not find that anywhere. So I got apples to juice and also a raw agave nectar or sweetener, I'm not sure, but a raw agave to use instead of the syrup. So you can interchange the sweeteners. So today I've started with the agave and I may try the apples tomorrow. We have started by each mixing up 8 servings of the lemonade, which is the juice of 4 lemons, a little less than a teaspoon of cayenne pepper, and 16 tablespoons of the sweetener. And I also have some maple water, which I may drink one of a day to receive some of the benefits with the maple without using the syrup. So if we get hungry after the 8 servings, we will just make more lemonade. But absolutely no other food. So finally, we will drink the herbal laxative tea at night, which we have already started by drinking last night. Now, to make this, I heated the water, but I did not boil it. So I'm not positive if that would be considered raw or not, but I'm going with it anyway because it's another important part of the process. So I am doing this master cleanse as close to raw as possible and still in line with my previous commitment. The most important thing to do when it comes to eating and cleansing is to listen to your body. And that is exactly what I'm doing. I'm listening to my body tell me to go for the thorough cleanse. It is important to, the majority of the time, eat based on your body's needs instead of instant gratification based on the taste of food. And doing cleanses like this really change your relationship with food. And now you're controlling what you put in your body based on health compared to just eating something for the taste of it. And a lot of times the tastiest foods are the ones that are addictive and cause disease and make you feel terrible. I do want to emphasize that this is not a starvation diet. All of the necessary calories, vitamins, and nutrients will be received through the lemons and the sweetener. And there will be plenty of glucose for the brain, because if you did not know, your brain runs on glucose. So when I am done with this cleanse, I will be continuing to eat the majority of raw foods, fruits and vegetables, juices and smoothies, with the addition of cooked foods, usually in a high carb, low fat ratio. But there will also be the addition of limited amounts of higher fat processed vegan foods, just because I love them. But again, they will be in limited amounts, with the majority of my diet being raw fruits and vegetables from here on out. And of course, my diet will always be vegan from now until forever. That will never change. 100% vegan for life. Day 19 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 2 of the master cleanse. So Jack and I are on the way to the gym to shoot some basketball and Zumba, and we both have our lemonade mixtures here. And today I use the raw agave syrup again. And also this morning I've been doing a little light running and some ab exercises.
Nothing but nips, baby. Oh, look at that.
I'm coming down.
She's coming down. I don't know what this move is. Oh, yeah.
See, man? I'm now spending a little bit of time in the sauna after basketball to kind of relax before Zumba, and I'm reading more about the master cleanse. Say hi, Simba. And I'm over here still drinking this lemonade, and I might as well get used to it because this is what I'm gonna be drinking for, well, 8 more days on the lemonade after this. So, yes, this is part of the struggle during a cleanse. I'm not hungry at all. I'm just thinking about all the foods I wish I could eat. But I'm staying strong on this because I do trust the process. I know I'm cleansing on the inside, and I am still pretty excited about that. So the taste of food will not be the end of it for me. So that's pretty much it for today, guys. Hey guys, it is day 21 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 4 of my 10-day master cleanse. So I am excited to say that after today, I will have only 1 week left until I can eat a cooked meal. So I'm pretty excited about that. But when I got home last night, I was going through some really harsh detox symptoms. Like, I was just out of it. Like, I feel nauseous and just like anxiety kind of, or just like really upset. And I know this is all like signs of detox and this is part of the process, but it was pretty rough last night. And I'm also breaking out everywhere. My tongue's like all white. I've been like trying to scrape at it and everything. So I know that these symptoms have come up ever since I transitioned to the Master Cleanse. So they say that you feel some of these symptoms throughout, and then closer to the end of the cleanse, all that stuff will go away and get better. So I'll be looking forward to that. But today I actually feel great and I woke up with plenty of energy. And I will tell you that, believe it or not, when drinking just the lemonade, you'd think that you might be low on energy or feel weak or something like that, but I have not felt like that one time. The whole time I've had plenty of energy and I haven't been hungry at all. I've just been feeling like I want to eat all different kinds of stuff, but not out of hunger. And I haven't had a lack of energy. Like the other day, I worked out for almost 3 hours in a row and didn't get feeling like I was going to pass out or anything like that, like you would expect. Jack is stalking me. Yeah, so I did get on the scale this morning and I'm about 14 pounds down altogether for the past 20 days. I did want to kind of take the emphasis off of the weight loss part of it, because that is not the only reason I'm doing this. I'm also intending to clean out my system and all the toxins and just get more energy, more clarity of mind, and all the other benefits that come with doing something like this. And so far I've had so many ups and downs. I've like cried my eyes out a couple of times. Like, it kind of helps you release like old anger and fear and sadness that you've been holding on to. And I don't know how to explain it other than that. Like, you just go through a lot of emotions with things like this, but this is a process that's really great to go through. So you're not walking around with a whole bunch of old toxins and fears and just sludge and fat and probably like years worth of food stuck to your intestinal walls and like all kinds of other nasty stuff that I could go on for hours about. Hey guys, it is day 22 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 5 of my 10-day master cleanse. And I'm in the basement, so I'm hearing a little bit of an echo, so I apologize about that. But anyways, I'm feeling really good today. A lot of the detox symptoms are starting to go away. The breakouts almost clearing up and I'm not nauseous today. I am experiencing a little bit of back pain, but I looked that up. It's also a detox symptom that you feel when toxins are being released so close to the spine. So that's all that is. And I was craving so many different foods today, but again, not hungry. I had plenty of energy and I did not have anywhere that I was obligated to go today, which was like a first for me in so long. So I took the opportunity to get so much done around the house. I did tons of cleaning and everything like that. But when I'm in the house, it makes it harder not to eat anything. But of course I did not. I drank the saltwater flush this morning. I've been drinking the lemonade throughout the day and my tea is almost ready. So I did not do any exercise yet, so that is why I'm in the basement. I'm getting ready to do it now. Being that I didn't have any other reason to leave the house, I figured I am not gonna go to the gym either. Good morning, guys. It is day 23 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 6 of my 10-day master cleanse. And we are up very early this morning. And I just wanted to show you guys how to make the saltwater flush. Say good morning, Simma. So it is around 5:30 in the morning and I'm getting ready to make the saltwater flush. I realized I hadn't shown you guys how to do this yet, so I will this morning. And I've already measured out 32 ounces of water. And then I need 2 teaspoons of sea salt. And then you just heat the water. You don't bring it to a boil. You pretty much just want to warm it to body temperature and let the salt dissolve into the water. So that took about 30 seconds and everything is dissolved and it's warm to body temperature. So I'll pour it back into the jar. And then drink it. And you want to try to drink it within 10 minutes, but not too fast that you feel sick or like you're going to throw up. This does make you use the bathroom, but not in an uncomfortable way. About 30 minutes after you drink it, you'll probably be in the bathroom, and then about an hour and a half after you drink it, you'll be completely done. So this is why I'm up this early, getting this in and out early. And it doesn't bother you throughout the rest of your day, so you don't need to worry about being at work or whatever you have to do during the day. And honestly, it comes back out in the form that you drink it in. So, but it's not pee. So it is coming out the other way, but it does come out liquid, especially this far along in the cleanse, now that you really don't have anything or too much solid waste left inside of you, just whatever is being picked up from your intestinal walls or scraped off your intestinal walls or whatever might be left in your colon at this time. So this is a very healthy process to get all of that stuff out. So it's not gross. This is something that is cleansing and well worth it. So I will recommend you guys look into the master cleanse. Now I'm getting ready to juice these ingredients to make the lemonade. So I've got some apples as the sweetener and lemons. So whatever I do not use of this mixture, I will put in the refrigerator for later. So I will keep the apples and the lemons separate. And as I'm ready for each glass, I will then add the cayenne pepper and the water. It is best to drink each glass freshly juiced as soon as you make it. But if you don't have time for that, to make each glass separately, just put the sweetener and the lemon juice together and keep that separate. And when you're ready to drink the glass, just add the water then. And as soon as you add the water, drink it. So I am trying this today because earlier today, I had made a glass of the lemonade using the raw blue agave, which I have been using for the past 5 days. Because originally when starting this master cleanse, I was looking for a raw alternative to the maple syrup, being that I had previously committed to a 28-day raw food diet and I didn't want to break that. So I was looking for the cane juice that was recommended to me, and also the apples were recommended, and then this a lot of people were saying to use. So I thought it was fine, but I was pretty disturbed today while reading more of this book, The Master Cleanse, and stumbling across this paragraph here
which says agave is another sweetener that is becoming widely available, though it is not a good choice for the master cleanse. It is made from the agave plant, which is high in a compound called inulin, which is extracted as a dark juice, filtered to remove minerals, and heated to convert the inulin into fructose. Finally, it is concentrated to make syrup. Then it goes on to tell you more about why you should not use agave. So, I went back online to research a bit more, and of course, there's still people saying it's fine to use, go ahead and do it. But now I don't feel good about it. So I'm going to stop using it now, being that there's so much mixed information and I don't feel comfortable with it. I don't think even if it is fine to use, being that I'm not comfortable with it, I might not get the best results just because my mind isn't with it anymore. So today I'm using the apples. I'm gonna go search and see if I can find the cane juice anywhere. And if not, continue with the apples. And if the apples don't work out, last resort, I will go back to the maple syrup, even though it is not raw, which I wish I had done this at a time that I wasn't on a raw food diet. I would have just went ahead and used the maple syrup as suggested. But being that I only have 4 days left after this, I'm going to improvise and make my way through this as close to raw as possible. So here's what the apple and lemon mixture looks like when you're done juicing it. And here's all the pulp that you will not be ingesting, so you'll just be drinking the juice. And one thing I thought about after I made that last clip was, being that I was using a raw agave, I don't know for sure if the effects that he was talking about in the book would be the same. Being that it's raw, it might not be heated the same way as an unraw version of the blue agave. I'm just still not sure on it, so I'm not going to take my chances. I want to make sure I'm not doing my body more harm than good, being that it's getting tougher and tougher daily thinking about cooked food, so I want to make sure I'm getting the best results that I can. So again, out with the agave. So here I've added the water and I gave it a taste. It's not too bad. It's not as good as with the syrup, but it's not bad. It actually tastes a little bit more refreshing instead of so sweet. So I'm gonna go with this for a little
while. Now I'm warming up some detox tea. It is day 24 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 7 of my 10-day master cleanse, and I am so excited that it is getting so close to the end and I have not failed yet. So I pretty much only have 3 days after today on the master cleanse and 4 days after today on the raw food diet. So we just got up from Zumba and I am feeling so amazing, so energized, and so healthy today. So much so that I started thinking, like, I know I have 4 to 5 days left, but why would I stop now when I feel like I'm making so much progress on my health and I'm not quite at 100% my healthiest version? So I was almost thinking about extending the cleanse. But I've been looking so forward to Sunday and thinking about all the yummy cooked vegan food I can eat. But yeah, so I think I'm just going to end it on the day that I planned and maybe plan another cleanse in the near future to finish what I started. But I will definitely be going back to raw foods, majority of raw foods, on a daily basis with the addition of cooked meals at night, so it won't be too far off from a cleanse anyway. But yeah, I kind of got excited, like, well, maybe I'll just add time to this, and then I was like, no. So I am doing some work on my computer on the balcony with Luna, and check out these really awesome pants I found. I'm basically wearing around Luna on my legs. Two of her. So I really love these.
And I'm guessing they meant for these to be Halloween pants, but these are gonna be all the time pants for me because I love them.
Hey guys, it is day 25 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 8 of my 10-day master cleanse, and I'm feeling really good about that. I will tell you that it's getting harder and harder and harder to stick to this thing. I'm getting closer to Sunday when I'm able to eat cooked food, and I've been wanting to quit so many times, and I'm kind of in a funk right now, but other than being in a funk about that, I do feel amazing. I can see and feel a lot of improvements in my health, and I'm definitely going to start back up on another cleanse after a few days of a break, kind of. So I'll be planning out exactly what that will be, and I'll let you guys know in a future video. But I'm not finished with what I started. I think I mentioned that yesterday. So I am in the process of figuring out my next step in continuing this process. And other than that, just letting you see me today, hey, I'm still here, I'm still hanging in on this thing, and get back with you tomorrow. Hey guys, it is day 26 of my 28-day raw food diet and day 9 of my 10-day master cleanse, and I am so excited that it's so close to the end. And Jack and I are here getting ready to walk into the gym, do a few things here until we leave here and go to Fitness Connection for Zumba, which we're excited about. There are some new choreographies this week that we're trying to master, so we're really excited about that too. So Zumba was fun. I got a nice sweat. I'm very energized. It's a beautiful day. I have a lot of things to do, as usual, as every day, but I wanted to let you guys know that my energy levels are still so high, even the 9th day on the lemonade. So I know you'd probably think that, oh, all she's doing is drinking this lemonade, she must have no energy, she's not getting any protein, blah, 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 but that is the complete opposite. I am starting to have more and more energy daily. I don't calorie count. I drink the lemonade. If I'm hungry, I drink more. I don't like measure and look how many calories it's gonna be or anything like that. I just drink it. Hey guys, it is day 28 of my 28-day raw food diet. So that means I have finally reached the end of my 4-week challenge, and I am so happy about it. I feel fantastic. I've lost almost 20 pounds in 28 days, and I know a couple of those pounds will come back once I start eating cooked food, because that's just the food that'll be coming back inside me that digests a little bit slower, but that is fine because that was not fat loss. Those specific couple of pounds that will come back wasn't fat loss anyway, so I will not be upset about that. And I do have about 10 more pounds to lose, so my plan for that is to continue to eat majority of raw fruits and vegetables with the addition of cooked vegan meals, maybe not every day, but maybe once every other day or something like that. I will just see how it goes, but also in the gym on a regular basis. And yeah, though this is the end of the 28-day challenge, this is not the end of the videos. They may or may not be daily, but you will continue to hear from me, whether it be about this or about random other things that Jack and I do. And I am excited for future videos. Thank you so much for following my progress. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And yeah, I will talk to you guys again soon.